Oh, hey everyone. I was just taking a photo of a five-line skink before it scurried away. I'm Anna, an educator at the North Carolina Arboretum. Say, do you also love to take photos of what's living around you? By joining ecoEXPLORE, your photos could help real scientists, and you could earn cool badges and prizes like this snazzy trail camera, or even this awesome iPod Touch. Yes! To sign up, go to ecoexplore.net. I'm super pumped because ecoExplore is in its herpetology season, and herps are some of my favorite animals. But you might be wondering, what is a herp? It's not a word you hear very often. That's because herptiles is a word that combines two groups of animals that we're all familiar with, reptiles and amphibians. So what puts reptiles and amphibians in the same category? The same reasons that make these organisms so incredible. Just think of these mind-blowing herps. Some species of frogs, such as the wood frog, don't survive the winter by digging deep into the ground like other frogs do. How do they not freeze during the winter, you ask? Well, actually, they do freeze, and they freeze solid in order to survive the winter. Not only can herps survive extreme temperatures, they can also go long periods of time without food. Some species of rattlesnakes, for example, can go up to 2 years without eating food. Yet despite this, they continue to grow. But the amazingness doesn't stop here. Some herps, like snapping turtles, are so effective in their environment that they haven't needed to evolve for over 90 million years. Just think, snapping turtles were around when dinosaurs roamed the earth and dolphins looked like this. One of the main reasons why these creatures are so adaptive to their environments is because of their body chemistry. Just for a second, feel your forehead, and now feel an object near you. Which is warmer? Why is this? Our bodies must maintain a constant warm temperature, and in doing so, we consume a lot of energy. But not so for our hoppy and slithery friends. By being cold-blooded, they depend on their surrounding environment to control their body temperature. Without their bodies having to keep them warm all the time, herptiles can slow their metabolism way down and use very little energy in the process. But despite being so different from humans, herps are like us too. All reptiles and amphibians are vertebrates, like us, meaning they have a backbone and skeleton under their skin. And like us, most have lungs. With so many similarities to each other, reptiles and amphibians are often lumped together. But if you dig a little deeper, you'll find it's also their differences that make them so fascinating. Let's use this Venn diagram to see their similarities and differences. We've already mentioned a few things that make them similar. But they are different in that most reptiles lay their hard-shelled eggs on land, whereas amphibians lay their soft, gel-covered eggs in water. Reptiles also have dry, scaly skin compared to amphibians with soft, smooth skin. And maybe the biggest difference lies in their life cycle. Although reptiles can live on land and water, they begin their lives on land. Amphibians begin their lives in water, breathing air through their gills and through their skin. Amphibians also go through an amazing transformation called metamorphosis, where their body form changes entirely as they move from water to land. Now that we have a basic understanding of what makes herps alike and different, let's go find some. Here are a couple helpful tips of where you could find them. If it's a sunny day, Look for places where a lizard might be sunning herself, like on a rock or concrete. If you're near a pond, look for an aquatic turtle that might be basking on a log. Or you can look for a frog that might be hiding in the grass along the shoreline. If you're in a park or the woods, look under rocks or logs for salamanders, or in tall grasses for snakes. But remember, some snakes can be venomous, so it's important to keep your distance if you're lucky enough to see one. Also, try looking for herps at different times of the day. Early evening is a great time to hear amphibians, such as frogs, call out to each other. Remember, no matter where or what time, herps can be scared pretty easily, so it's important to move slowly when you're around them. And stay a little quiet, too. With a new field season comes a new badge to earn, the herpetology badge. To earn this badge, you must take 6 photos of herps, reptiles, and amphibians, and submit them to your ecoEXPLORE account. In addition, you must complete 3 out of the 4 challenges and upload them to your user dashboard. Well, I'm off to go find a few more herps. Good luck, have fun, keep exploring.